And this is day two at TIFF, and we're back with Anthony Del Col again and Thelma Adams, the legendary Thelma Adams. Hey, Thelma.
Hey, Steven.
You know, you started me on this whole film festival thing. Yes, she did. You were the first
you're
person.
You're responsible.
Okay. Yeah, I am responsible.
You created the monster.
Only that day.
Montreal.
Yeah,
Montreal. It all began at Montreal.
And I didn't even know what it was or where it was. And then all this
a lovely festival. And here we are in Canada again. We have to stop meeting like this.
Yes, at the Toronto Film Festival. And we're here to talk about Oscars with my co-host, Anthony Del Col. We've just seen a whole bunch of movies today, and I just saw Dangerous Method, and I hated it.
You know, it's interesting because it is about the birth of psychoanalysis, Freud and Jung. I think it's David Cronenberg. It's very smart. It's very interesting, and I think it's very adult. And one of the things I liked about it was it showed me a story that I wasn't aware of before. At the same time, it's a period piece, and all the period details are perfect.
Yes.
And yet the people aren't stiff. It's Keira Knightley, Viggo Mortensen, Vincent Cassell, and Michael Fassbender. What a cast.
And they were all completely wasted. But what
really?
You think? Did you see it?
I haven't seen it yet. I see the gala tomorrow night, so we can get back together and discuss opinion.
I don't think we need a deciding vote. I think that the red carpet is long. I think that Cronenberg always divides people. This is one of his most...
I was never a fan.
Yeah, I'm a huge fan, and this is one of his most polished works. I can actually say to you, okay, I can see some flaws in the movie. It is not the perfect movie, but it is so brilliant at the same time.
How does it compare to his last two, Eastern Promises and History of Violence?
It's very different because there's no violence.
There's no violence. Oh, well, there is an S&M scene, and that was good.
Very tame. It's it's the tamest S&M scene you'll probably ever see, you know. And apparently there's a lot in this movie, Shame, that's coming up
with Fassbender.
Yeah, but this...
Love Michael Fassbender, yes.
This was not it. And I think it's interesting because it's about the birth of psychoanalysis and the decisions that Freud and Jung made and their father-son relationship and their competitive relationship.
Oh, no.
And I wasn't aware of that. I also thought it was interesting. There's something that probably won't be discussed, that Jung believed in telepathy. He believed, he didn't want to divorce psychoanalysis from other kind of interesting psychic forces, that he saw that there were other psychic forces and he felt that that should be explored in tandem. And according to this, it's fiction to a certain extent, Freud said, no, we're going to have a hard enough time getting our psychosexual agenda across. Let's not muddy the waters.
Interesting. But they don't explore that in the film.
No, they do. They do. There's something
it's
else.
Very boring, prosaic. Wait, I wanted to ask Anthony about the film you saw last night.
Oh, The Ides of March.
Yes. Did you see that?
Yes, I've seen it.
I haven't seen it.
Yes. Oh, I haven't seen it. Okay, sure.
Discuss.
Ides of March. I mean, I enjoyed it. I thought it was good, but I didn't think it was great.
I thought it was good. People are very gentle. I think that everybody is in such, and I love George Clooney.
This is the George Clooney movie about politics.
Yes. About politics.
Yeah. And he directed too.
Yeah.
Right. And is in it.
And there's such Clooney mania right now that I feel people feel bad if they kind of say, George...
Yes,
it's oleo, not butter.
Yeah. I think that's true. Yeah. And what do you say?
Overall, I did enjoy it. I thought the performances were good. I thought Ryan Gosling was quite good in the lead.
Starring as Hamlet and Kill Shakespeare,
of course. Yes. It is a very good cast. I mean, Philip Seymour Hoffman.
No, he did.
Not yet. Paul Giamatti is good. Yeah. For me, it was. There's nothing really original in it. I mean,
oh, well, that's not
Because the film is all about politics and how politics corrupts.
We know that.
So unfortunately, in this day and age, you can't make Mr. Smith Goes to Washington anymore. There are no Mr. Smiths around.
He's supposed to be
Ryan Gosling plays like an idealistic press agent or press secretary.
They're saying that it's a staffer, in contemporary terms, you would call him a media analyst or a media strategist.
Yeah, exactly. So Ryan Gosling plays a campaign organizer for George Clooney, who's running in the Ohio primaries for the Democratic.
And he's got another
leader.
Movie here too, which we both just
yes, which
saw.
Drive,
Drive.
Yes, yes,
Have you
yes.
Seen Drive?
Yes, I've seen Drive as well, which is kind
loved
of Steve
it.
McQueen. You know that? We can shift onto that one too.
Yeah.
I think I've got to say that Ides of March and Drive have similar problems, which is the women problems, which is they've cast women because of what they look like, and they don't help the movie. By casting women who are basically Barbie dolls, not that they're not good actresses, Evan Rachel Wood and Carey Mulligan, both good actresses, but both miscast or misused in these two movies.
Now why do you think that Carey Mulligan was miscast?
Well, she looked like Michelle Williams. She does look very Williams.
I thought she was good.
Very good actress. There's not a moment she's believable as a Denny's waitress who's living with a gangbanger.
That's true.
Not with that dye job.
Yeah.
We just got to say that. I know that you have many things to do today. I don't want to keep you. Forever.
Well, anyway, we were discussing the Oscars, and have you seen the Tilda Swinton movie?
Excellent.
I saw it too.
It's tough.
It really is. It's disturbing.
Not only is it tough, but it is divisive. It's another movie that's love hate.
We have to talk about Kevin, is the name.
Yeah.
Yeah, we have to, which is, I think, again, we have to talk about these titles that are tough. I cannot get that one off my tongue.
I almost didn't either.
A dangerous method, I keep calling a dangerous mind.
Yes, I do too.
Ides of March, I'm not having any problems. Descendants, I'm doing okay.
But the one Ides of March is much better because the original title was Farragut North, and no one outside of Washington would understand.
The Ides of March is very Shakespearean, of course, cutting, plugging, kill Shakespeare. But you also saw another movie earlier today.
I saw The Artist.
What did you think?
I saw The Artist. You know,
he hadn't seen it
that's
before.
Interesting. He's taking a deep breath.
I am, because
he doesn't love it as much as
there's been so much hype over that film since it debuted at Cannes. From Sasha at awardsdaily.com, I went in with really high expectations, and it was a very good film, but I was expecting a little more commentary, like, what are you trying to say about the silent era, and why are you doing it in this particular thing?
It, but what did you?
I don't know.
What did you say?
I didn't get it.
I would say, in general, it's about the ability to reinvent yourself. And so here's a guy, and that's where it steps away from just being about movies. It's about a big star in the silent films who can't make a transition to talkies, and the way he handles it is to become depressed, morose, and he has a downward spiral, and then he comes happily out of it, and he reinvents himself. He finds a new place
for his brave dog, best dog ever.
But I think that people now in our climate, it's not like up in the air exactly, but people have to reinvent themselves. People's careers are ending. They have to figure out what they really want to do, what they can do, the environment. Even now as we're speaking, newspapers are going, magazines are going, the digital era, what's it going to be? You've learned skills. How do you transfer it? How do you translate it? And I think in that way, it really is a timely movie. And at the same time, it's uplifting.
Yes.
Don't get me wrong. I really did enjoy it. I just thought that, like, the story itself was so predictable. Like, you knew every single beat that was going to go on with the main character.
Well, it's because you're so smart, Anthony. I was just swept away.
The music was great. The performances are great. The ending is fantastic.
Right.
And you noticed they slipped in the theme from Vertigo. I like that.
Oh, I love that.
That was fantastic. That was a nice addition.
Love that. But I have to tell you, Anthony, Thelma is also a best-selling author.
Oh.
And I never got to tell you.
Novel is called Playdate, which is very easy to remember.
I'd love to see a copy so now I can say it.
I know.
and talk about
your book. What is Playdate?
Playdate is kind of like in the movie form, it's kind of like Shampoo meets Mr. Mom.
Oh, it's about
It's about a stay-at-home dad who is living, it's during the course of Santa Ana Winds. It's set in a beach community in Southern California, and he has a daughter, and he and his wife are going through some difficult times, and he's cheating with another mother, and the babysitter comes on to him, Shampoo, remember?
Yeah.
And yet there's one woman who's his true love, and he has to, he's a passive guy, he has to make a decision in his life.
And did this book change your life?
It totally changed my life, yes.
Yes. No, it changed your career. I mean, it was this like hit, and Thelma was a critic and a journalist, and now you're a novelist.
I'm a novelist, and I like, you know, I love movies, and I think I learned a lot by watching a lot of movies.
By the way. I'm the first to tell you. Isn't she good?
Oh, yes, she is.
Oh, well, I didn't realize we were on the air. I just thought we were sitting around talking.
Film festival. We're on the top. We're at the Toronto Film Festival.
Oh, that.
To the people.
Oh, that. See, you know, if we go back to a dangerous method. I think
so
that my psychology is always, I only am aware of those people I'm sitting talking to you.
Oh,
you
that's
know?
Cool.
That's
and if you
question.
And if you're like that, then you
have
fun.
I'm only aware of who's ever on my show, and outside of it, I don't know who they are, what their
exactly.
names are.
It's true.
And talk about driving traffic. Every time I mention the word Melissa Leo on my blog or anywhere, who turns out to be Thelma's best friend, little did I, right through the roof, the heads go up. So I have to keep mentioning her. Now, she won the Oscar on her own
She's
terms.
Up for an Emmy now. Did you know that?
No,
she's up
I
for
didn't.
Mildred Pierce. She's
oh,
going
Mildred Pierce,
for
you're
Best
right.
Best Supporting
yes.
Actress. And there's going to be a Mildred Pierce sweep. Todd Haynes, Christine Vachon, Killer Films,
yep.
Produced it. Todd Haynes directed and wrote it. Kate Winslet is up for the title role.
Yep.
Evan Rachel Wood. And Mayor Winningham. So there's going to be a big night again for Melissa. It is an insanely huge.
And she's like one of your closest.
She's
friends.
One of my closest.
And why didn't you tell
friends?
Her what was going to happen when she started taking out those ads, Thelma? And she didn't know she was the front runner. Hello.
You know what?
She really didn't.
She really didn't. And this is why. And I think this is. It's kind of one of those things that you have to understand is that actors are people too, and she's been. She's a woman. She just crossed into over 50. She's been doing this since her teens. She has always been the underdog. She has never gotten anything easily or for free. And she was still running on that adrenaline.
She's, unbelievable. You know, now, what she did, what happened was that Melissa Leo was the front runner winning all these awards. And then she took out these ads, which you were present when they shot them, I think.
Well, they shot them in my neighborhood. I did
oh, really?
Go. And I thought
I
the
thought
little Steven caught
tell.
Me out. I love her to death. And everybody has friends. You can only tell them once.
Yeah. Yep.
And you hope that they're right and you're wrong.
Well,
yep.
You know...
And in the end,
she won it anyway. She did. She won it on her own terms, despite what I said, what anybody else said. She won it her way, and so that's great.
And what I would like to say about her, you know, everyone knows
she's
a great actress, but she has such a good heart.
Okay.
And when we talk about friendship, she's one of, she just opens her heart as a friend and is amazing. As good at that as she is as an actress.
I always felt that, and I wanted to say, Melissa, be in my next play, okay? Anyway, I'm a playwright too. Yeah.
Well, that seems to have covered the...
We covered the Melissa Leo waterfront, and she won, she did it her way, and... You know, I think it's great that your friend, and I think it's great that she took a stand and said women over 50 deserve to be on talk shows, deserve to be on covers of magazines, because that's what she was getting
well,
all.
The big struggle is
it's
that,
true.
That women, mature women, older than Evan Rachel Wood, older than Carey
Mulligan,
deserve their own dramatic arc. And one of the things I learned, that I've learned from Melissa Leo, is that women need to have their own narrative arc.
Yes,
they need to have
us.
And
brought that to the fore.
But we're still not seeing enough movies where that's true. What's the matter? You know, we need to talk about Kevin with Tilda Swinton.
Which
is an example.
Herself.
Yeah, is an example of her finding a role, the actress finding a role that's intelligent, that showcases her talent. And I think what will happen, because I'm an optimistic person, is that in the next decade you will see women writing their own stories, like The Help.
Yeah. Which is like what you're doing.
Which is like what I'm doing.
And, you know, you're in the forefront of all that, and I am too. I mean, I love stories about women, not little girls, you know.
Well,
and like in Kill Shakespeare, you've got your heroine, Juliet.
Well, Juliet, but Lady Macbeth.
And Lady Macbeth.
Yeah.
Don't you always want to know, you know, what was it like when Lady Macbeth was growing up? Who was her mother, her father? Was she the young? I don't think she was the youngest.
I bet Melissa Leo would know the answer to that question. She's probably given it a lot of thought.
She would know how to play that character
She would be very good.
She would be good, yeah.
Let's get this to her.
All right, well, listen.
Okay, thank you very much.
Adams,
yes, thank you.
And Anthony Del Col here again at the Toronto Film Festival, Day 2, 2011. Have a fabulous